remember the sweater that I made last month. In the second part of the series, I used the calculating charts given in the Passap ABC book. When you first see them, you may think there is some magic behind the numbers in those tables. But this is not true, and there is a very simple explanation. The answer is hidden in a short mathematical formula, or this one, that can be pasted into Excel. You don't need to rewrite it, because I will paste it in the description. But let's start from the beginning. If you aren't familiar with these tables, I will quickly tell you how to use them. At first, you must knit a test swatch by using 100 stitches and make it 100 rows using the yarn for your project in the exact stitch pattern and stitch size. Otherwise, you can't use the tables. After knitting your test swatch, put it in your washing machine, then wait until it dries and treat it the same way as you plan to treat the garment. If you are planning to iron the garment, you have to iron the test swatch as well. After all of that is done, measure your test swatch and write down the width and the length. Let's say the length of your test swatch is 44 cm. First, you have to find the right table to use. Now let's calculate how many rows you have to knit if you want your garment to be 25 cm long. Find the conjunction between the number 44 in the top row and the number 20 in the leftmost column. The number is 45. Then find the conjunction between the number 44 in the top row and the number 5 in the leftmost column. The number is 11. Now we have to add 45 and 11. The result is 56. This means that you have to knit 56 rows to make a piece that will be 25 cm long. Now I will explain to you how the tables work. This is the mathematical formula used in all of the calculation tables. The number 100 is the stitches or the rows we have knitted to make the test square. The letter X can be used for the length or the width of the test square. These values are in the top row of the table. The letter Y is used for the desired predefined width or length of the piece you want to knit. These values will be in the first and the last columns of the table. Let's see the formula I made once again. If you don't have Excel, you may use it in OpenOffice or other similar programs. Make sure the format of the formula is suitable for the program and the region where you live. My version of Excel uses semicolons in the formula, but yours can use commas. As you can see, I have added some rules so Excel can make all operations for you. Some of the most important things I tried to include are rounding up the numbers and limiting the highest number shown in the table to 358. You may ask why I have limited the biggest result to 358, and the reason is very simple. The sum of all needles on both beds on the machine is 358, and if you are calculating stitches for the width of the project, you won't get confused by looking at the wrong numbers. After you print out the tables, you may use colored pencils to color code them. This way you will always know if you are using the right table to make the calculations. In the description you can find and download a black and white version of these tables and a colored one in case you have a color printer. Now you can see how I will make the tables. First, I have to open Excel. In cell A1, I will type cm because I will make the table in centimeters. In the same column, but in the cells below, I will put the numbers for the desired length or width of the fabric. We must have all single-digit numbers up to 10, then all round numbers up to 90 to be able to make all of the calculations possible. In the top row, I have to insert all possible sizes of the test swatch. I will need to make several different tables to fit all sizes possible. Now I will format the table so you can easily see how the magic formula will make the calculations for us. There is a special button where you can select one of the built-in styles, but I will never need to make any changes, so I can do everything one by one. At this point, you can paste the formula. I didn't have the formula prepared, so I will type it in the formula bar instead. The most important thing is that you must paste the formula into the cell B2. Otherwise, it won't work or you have to correct the cell name in the formula. After you paste the formula, you can press Enter to confirm and the result should appear in that cell. Now select cell B2 again and copy the formula along the first column, then across the whole table. We are almost done. To make the table fit on the sheet of paper, I will select the whole document and set the width of the cells to automatic. This will remove the empty space and will make the table look better. Now the first table is ready and we can make the other ones or use this file as a dynamic calculation table. If you change the numbers in the first two cells as shown in the video, you can then easily change all the numbers on the row and the second table will be ready. The cells will be automatically updated with the new calculations. That's all for today. Have a nice day and see you next time.